God's word that guides our thoughts tonight is the gospel. Matthew chapter 4, verses 12 to 17. When Jesus heard that John had been put in prison, he returned to Galilee. Leaving Nazareth, he went and lived in Capernaum, which was by the lake in the area of Zebulun and Naphtali, to fulfill what was said through the prophet Isaiah. At Zebulun, the land of Naphtali, the way to the sea along the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles, people living in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, the light has dawned. From that time on, Jesus began to preach, repent, for the kingdom of God is near. Dear friends, it's time. I wonder how often we have heard words like that. It's time. Maybe you heard them in your house this evening as it was getting time to get in the car and go to church. Come on, it's time. Church is about ready to start. Let's go. It's time. We better get to the hospital. This baby is about to be born. Or if you are a child, maybe you can hear these words. Get up. Time to get to school. It's time. On and on we can go with examples of using that phrase. It's time. Circumstances are just right. Whatever we've been waiting for, it is here. Come on, let's go. It's that phrase captures the heart of our scripture. Time to end the spiritual blackout. Time to repent. So that you may blackout. We know what a blackout is. It's when the power fails and the lights go out. We had an extended blackout here in this area. The storms ripped through, the power lines went down, and lights went out. No street lights illuminating the corners. No warm sun. A blackout can certainly be an inconvenience to the schedule here. People were scurrying around looking for candles and flashlights and lanterns as we prepared for that wedding during the blackout. Finally, the power came on. But certainly a little bit of inconvenience. Maybe you had a bit of inconvenience. Blackouts can also be dangerous. When you can't see, you can easily stumble over something that normally you would have walked right around, or if the corners of the streets are dark, accidents can happen. They're dangerous. Blackouts are inconvenient, they're dangerous. The people in our scripture text were experiencing, and really had been for centuries, had been experiencing a spiritual blackout. Our reading talks about the people of Zebulun and Naphtali. Perhaps you remember those are a couple of tribes, the Israelites. When Israel conquered the Promised Land, not next week.